Hello my friends, γεια σας φίλοι μου, welcome back, καλώς ήρθατε. This is an introductory lesson to the Greek personal pronouns. Today we're going to learn what the personal pronouns are, when we use them, and we're going to explore their grammar and their different forms. We're going to do all that in close comparison to the English personal pronouns. I want you to understand that the Greek personal pronouns have the exact same function as the English personal pronouns. The only difference is that the Greek personal pronouns have more forms, but they don't express anything different. For example, in Greek, the personal pronoun you has 12 different forms. So, in English, you would translate all of these 12 words as you. Okay, let's begin. And first of all, let's make sure that we all know what a personal pronoun is. So, the personal pronouns in most languages are words that can replace nouns. Let's see an example. John loves Maria. In Greek, ο Γιάννης αγαπάει τη Μαρία. So, we have two nouns that we can replace with a personal pronoun. John and Maria. John is the subject of the verb. It's a male person, so we use the personal pronoun he to replace John. And Maria is the object of the verb, a female person, so we use the word her to replace Maria. He loves her. The exact same thing happens in Greek. Ο Γιάννης αγαπάει τη Μαρία becomes αυτός την αγαπάει. The only difference is that in Greek we can go a bit further and omit he, αυτός, and the final sentence is την αγαπάει. In English this is absolutely forbidden, but in Greek this is the rule. If we use the word αυτός in Greek, the sentence gets a slightly different meaning. We'll see about that later. Don't worry about that now. Let's make sure that we know the English personal pronouns. There are two types, the subject personal pronouns and the object personal pronouns. The subject personal pronouns replace the subject of the verb, and the object personal pronouns replace the object of the verb. There are three persons, both singular and plural. There are also three genders for the third person singular, but not three genders in the plural. And that's it. Let's now continue with the Greek personal pronouns. Don't get scared, they are a bit more complicated, but we're going to see everything in much more detail, and of course practice is going to help us a lot. Okay, so let's spot the differences between the English and the Greek personal pronouns. To begin with, they are a lot more. Apart from that, the most obvious difference is that there are two types of personal pronouns, the strong forms and the weak forms. That's the main difference that stands out. So, the strong forms are used for emphasis. We use them to emphasize who did something, or to whom something happened, or to distinguish someone or something from someone or something else. A very quick example here. In English, you say, "It's you I love, not her." So that's a case where we need to emphasize both you and her. We're making a distinction here. So we'll say εσένα αγαπώ, όχι αυτήν. Both εσένα and αυτήν are strong forms of the personal pronoun. One last thing about the strong forms of the personal pronouns, they are called strong because they can't stand by themselves in a sentence. So if we ask who is it, ποιος είναι, you can use the strong form of the personal pronoun and just say εγώ, I, or it's me. A weak form could never do that. Okay, let's continue with the weak forms, which are much more common. They are not used for emphasis, but in simple sentences. I won't say much here, we're going to see the strong forms and the weak forms in much more detail in different videos. Now it's just an introduction. So let's continue with the second difference between the Greek and the English personal pronouns, which is, of course, the cases. Personal pronouns in Greek are declinable, they have cases. But if you have watched my cases video, you know that nominative is the case of the subject of the verb and genitive and accusative are for the object of the verb. Some verbs get an object in the genitive, most verbs get an object in the accusative. And finally, vocative is used to address someone directly. That's exactly how we use the cases for the pronouns too. Let's see them one by one. First, nominative. Nominative is the case of the subject. That's exactly what the nominatives of the personal pronouns do. And especially the strong forms. The weak forms, as you can see, exist only in the third person and they are used in very specific situations. So we are not going to talk about them now. We're going to keep the strong forms and see what they can do. Exactly. They can replace only the subject of the verb. They're just like I, you, he, she, it, we, you, they in English. And if you remember from the beginning of this lesson, if we don't need to emphasize for some reason, we omit them. Let's continue with the genitive. As I said before, some verbs get an object in the genitive case. They are not many, but they are some of the most common Greek verbs. So, we'll use the genitive case of the personal pronouns, especially the weak forms, very, very often. Let's continue with the accusative. Same thing, most Greek verbs get an object in the accusative case, so also very important. And finally, vocative. As I said before, we use vocative to address someone directly, so obviously we only need the vocative case in the second person, both singular and plural. So the vocative is like saying, hey, you! Only two forms and that's it. So, we saw the differences between the strong forms and the weak forms and the different cases of the personal pronouns. There is only one more difference, if you have noticed by now, and that's the gender. In English, only the third person singular has three genders. In Greek, the third person plural has three genders too. So, these were the three main differences. Now, I want to show you how we translate the Greek personal pronouns in English, word by word. I'll do that because I want you to realize that it's the same pronouns. Greek pronouns don't express anything different than English pronouns. They are just more specific. Let's begin. I. Εγώ. Quite simple. Let's now see you, second person. In English, you is very versatile. It can be used for singular, plural, subject, and object. In Greek, there are 12 different forms, and they all mean you. He, third person, singular, masculine gender. There is the strong form, αυτός, and the weak form that is used in very specific cases. Same thing for she. It is common for both subject and object pronouns in English, so that's why in Greek there are more forms. We, nominative, first person plural, only one Greek form for we. We saw you before, let's continue with they. Let's not forget three genders in the plural, strong and weak forms. And let's continue with the object English pronouns. Me, first person singular. It replaces the object of the verb, so it can be in genitive or accusative. And of course, there are weak and strong forms. I don't think I need to explain the rest. Him, her, us, and finally them. We don't forget the three genders in the plural too. There are so much to say about the personal pronouns, but I think we covered the most basic facts about them in this introductory lesson. There are going to be separate videos for the strong forms and the weak forms so that we can see many examples and understand what's going on with the Greek personal pronouns. If you have any questions, leave a comment, of course. Before I end this lesson, I would like to thank you once more for your support and your beautiful comments. And I have an important announcement to make. In a few days, I'm going to leave Greece and I will move to Brussels for about 6 months. I'm so excited about that. But, at least for a while, I'm not sure what my internet situation is going to be or if I will have enough time to make as many videos as I want. So please forgive me in advance for any delay. It's not intentional and I'm going to do my best to make and upload as many videos as I can. If you want to stay updated, I suggest that you follow my Facebook page. I will have the link below. So, that was it, my friends. Thank you for watching. Keep studying. See you next time. Bye-bye. Γεια σας.